A car out of one. I pray this devil died and get every evil thing the Lord got to give. And listen, I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Come your child.
Come
your child.
Come your child.
I know you look at us in the state we in right now. Black people on drugs and we suffering and dying. And I know it seems like you can do whatever you want to this people. I know it seems like this, but the time for glorifying yourself is soon at an end.
The ones that come to the law, the laws of this Bible. Let's find out. Where you at? Go ahead. Deuteronomy 28:1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Right, so if black man, if you come to hearken, if you hearken and do the laws and obey the voice of the Lord, you get a reward for that. You're not following the laws of God for nothing. It's a reward that comes with that. Let's find out our reward for following the laws of God. Go ahead.
To observe and to do all his commandments.
Right, it got to be an action. It can't be, oh, I love God. It has to be an action. We got to show God by our duty, by our deeds, by our actions. Go ahead.
And do all his commandments, which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high.
Hold on, wait a minute, man, you're lying. This Bible didn't say that. The Lord said what?
The Lord thy God will set thee on high.
Black man, you come back to Hispanic man, you come back to God, you follow his laws. The Lord said he's gonna set you on high, but that's not it. And where is high? High is right here. This is what black people are right now. We low, we the lowest. We up under everybody's feet. But the Lord said he gonna set us on high. Let's find out where. Go ahead.
Above all nations.
Above who?
All nations.
Above who?
All nations.
Above the white man.
All nations.
Above the Chinese.
All nations.
Above the East Indian.
All nations.
Above the Arab.
All nations. That are upon the earth.
Upon who?
The earth.
No, not on earth, on planet Mars.
The earth.
We're talking about Pluto.
The earth.
On the earth, right here. Right here, man.
Right.
The Lord said, black man, Hispanic man, the children of Israel, you follow the laws of God, you're going to be set above high on earth. What that mean? You are going to rule. Ain't no more White House, man. It's you, man.
Right.
Ain't no more capital. Ain't no more going hand in hand. Ain't no voting, man. It's you having a crown on your head. Ain't no joining these other nations, man. It's not gonna be a Chinese ruling earth in that day. It ain't gonna be no African, no Arab, man. It ain't gonna be no. It's not gonna be democracy on the earth. It's gonna be a monarchy, man. We're gonna be following one king, a black man named Jesus Christ. And black man, you'll be a king too on the earth, ruling the sections of the earth that he give to you, man. Black man, you don't know you can rule a whole country or maybe a whole continent. That's with the Lord. But we gonna find out that. But that's how you're gonna get it. My father laws, man, go back. Let's go back, man. But none of this is gonna happen if we keep following these false leaders. These false leaders are not telling us what's in this Bible. They are telling us what the white man agenda is, man, what the white man wants us to do. Now our preachers is telling black people to stay asleep. Our preachers telling black people to bend over and take it. That's what they tell us. Just take it. Just lay down on the ground and let the white man step all over you. Hell no. We ain't gonna let it. The IHBK ain't gonna let it happen. The prophets of the Lord ain't gonna let it happen. And God ain't gonna let it happen, man.
That's right.
Go ahead.
Jeremiah 29:8. For thus saith the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, let not your prophets and your diviners that be in the midst of you deceive you.
Right, man. Don't let our shop, don't let the prophets or the divines that be in the midst of you deceive you, man. Don't let our shop deceive you. Some old march. What would march and beg a white man for peace? talking about marching. Marching have not done a damn thing, man. Once again, we've been marching since the time of Martin Luther King, and there has not been no progress on the earth. Marching just made the white man more rich. Integration just made the white man more rich. Black man, we were segregated. At least we had our own stores and our own companies and our own business. Black man, what you got now? Not a damn thing. Why? Because when we integrated, the white Martin Luther King taught us. Nah, man. What Martin Luther King teach us? We went to those white stores. These white stores had a sign that said colors only. Martin Luther King said, these white stores said no colors, no colors allowed. Martin Luther King said, nah, even though the white man don't want us in the store, we gonna force him to take our money. We gonna force him. Ain't that craziness? That's BS. Like that's crazy, like think about it, black man. Really, really, truly sit back and let it sink in. A people hate you. A person hates you. He hates you so much. I hate you so much, I'ma put in my store. No colors allowed. Martin Luther King is saying, damn that sign, walk in that sign, and give that man that hate you, give him your money.
Right.
That don't make no damn sense. The white man is saying, give your enemy, Martin Luther King basically saying, give your enemy your money. And when that happened, we went to his businesses, and we lost our businesses, man. That's why today, a black man got nothing. We got no business. We got no stores. We got few stores, man. Say it, sir. Right, and you don't know, and just like that, those white stores that said no colors allowed. When you went in there and tried to eat in the stores or something that said no colors allowed, you don't know what those devils put in your food, man. They hate you, man. You don't know what they put in your food. Go ahead.
Neither hearken to them, neither hearken to your dreams, which ye cause to be dreamed.
Right. The Lord said, don't listen to your dreams, man. You want to know, and don't not listen to those prophets that's lying. When Michael Brown and Trayvon Martin got shot, we were not supposed to go and beg the white man. We were supposed to see a sign. What we're supposed to do is be smart. And look and do the Bible said, do the Bible said, look at history. Now, it's just like how the judges and the officials keep records of a criminal. When a person gets locked up, your rap sheet come up, your record come up, and it says, okay, this person, he's been locked up for robbery before. This person, he's been locked up for murder before. He's been locked up for theater before. Well, damn. A black man, when you get killed by a white man, let's pull up the white man's rap sheet.
Right.
Let's pull up his history.
Right.
And show and see that the white man is the devil, man. And let's see his rap sheet. Okay, let's start from the beginning. Let's start from the America time. The rap sheet, the crime that a white man committed was when he killed 77 Native American Indians, 77 million Native American Indians, man.
Right.
America was filled with 77 million Native American Indians. And the white man killed them all.
That's right.
And pushed the few that was left to reservations.
Right.
What's another crime? The white man is a criminal. He's a murderer and a rapist on the earth. And a thief. He's the biggest murderer. Right. He does mass murder, man.
Right.
Black man, you can never do a mass murder like this devil, man.
Right.
This devil make fire rain from the earth. He got drones, he got tanks. He come to countries and continents and take over and kill and murder with no passion, no love.
Right.
He built America on blood.
That's right.
And say, God bless America. The white man is the devil on the earth.
Right.
How the white man gonna say peace and love when you come and kill 77 million Native American Indians? You are the devil, man.
Right.
What's another crime he did? He killed 99 million of us, 99 million Negroes, and just in the transatlantic slave trade alone. He kidnapped us, man. We were in Africa, man. We from Israel. We ran from the white man and from the Romans into Africa. These devils came to Africa and kidnapped us.
Right.
And kidnapped Negroes and brought them over here, man. In chains. On a slave ship, on a cargo slave ship, and beat us. made us forget our heritage, made us forget our name. Yo, y'all saying Roots? He said, nah, you ain't cool to kids that your name Toby. He beat you and beat you until you obey to him, until you obey to him, man. And forced us into Christianity, man. And it forced us into loving him. That's just like a black man, that black man, black woman, that's just like your son and your daughter. Somebody raped your son and daughter. And now you saying, go and love the rapists that raped you, man. And matter of fact, join the same beliefs that he believed in. Do the same that he do. That's exactly what happened, man. Go ahead.
Jeremiah 29:9. For they prophesied falsely unto you in my name.
Right, Al Sharpton and Jesse Jackson does what?
Prophesied falsely unto you in my name.
All these Christian pastors and preachers do what?
Prophesied falsely unto you in my name.
These Catholic priests that's led to our Hispanic brothers do what?
Prophesied falsely unto you in my name.
These priests and prophets, these Christian pastors, these Catholics, Al Sumner, Jesse Jackson, these black leaders, the black caucus, prophesied falsely in the Lord's name. His name is Reverend Al Sharpton, but damn, he teaches nothing but the Bible. If you open up his Bible, you're going to see that the Lord says separate from this devil. That he will have a perpetual hatred, a continual hatred for you, man. They are lying, man. These prophets are lying. These black preachers are saying that the white man is our friend. They are lying, man. What's the evidence? Like I said, look at the white man's history. Look at his history. Pull up a rap sheet. He is a criminal. Pull up his crime. He go to continents and kill everybody in the countries and continents and take over. Right. And then force them to believe in his Christianity, man.
Right.
He's an unconscious beast. Right. He's an uncompassionate beast.
Right.
He is a murderer, man. He killed 77 million Native American Indians. He did not ask the Native American Indians, and guess what?
Right.
When the white devil came over here, what happened? The Native American Indians were so kind enough to teach him how to survive over here, man, and how to take care of himself. Once he learned all the knowledge from those Native American Indians, he took that knowledge and then killed the Native American Indians, man.
My man.